today is the big day. Finally, yeah. We got some sailing.
Yeah.
And we're going to do a big jump now. Where are we going?
We are going to leave Martinique, and we're going to USVI, St. John.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we are heading north. We're going up to the east coast of USA.
Yes.
And going north of the hurricane belt, which is like 30 degrees north.
Yeah. So we are very excited, and of course we are having, we call it in Swedish, travel fever. I don't know the name of it in English, but you're a little bit nervous.
Yeah.
We haven't been sailing for 7 weeks.
No, we've been here since the 20th of February.
Yeah.
And haven't done much sailing since then, especially not the last 6 weeks.
No.
So that's that is a good feeling. Mm-hmm. And now it was, I mean, we have had a waiting game, and finally when we took the decision to move, it felt a lot better.
Yes.
The decision now feels very good, but it's not obvious because a lot of other boats, there's like one third goes home back to Europe, and one third is staying down in the Caribbean, trying to get the boat in the hard and go home, and then one third is going north, and we decided to go north.
Yeah,
and we're quite excited to go to the U.S. and we're very happy that we got the visa before we left, so we actually can go there.
Yeah. So the last week we have done so many things, like preparing for this trip. So, but it's also now I'm very exciting because
It's been very good for the boat.
Yeah.
Because we have done something every day.
Yeah.
And that's I think Svea is.
I think she's in mint condition
now.
Yeah,
better. Everything is working and everything is like maintained. And it's in a good shape. Not everything. You will always find something to do. It's,
but and it's a 10-year-old boat, so you can't have
the to-do list is a lot shorter than
before.
Yeah.
But the thing we're most happiest about is that our autopilot is working. That's why we are able to do this long sail.
Yeah. We bought a new one, and that wasn't the error still remained. But luckily, we had a technician checking the installation, so we got the warranty.
Yeah.
And he found the error like in 20 minutes time or less.
Yeah, less I would say. Mm.
It was the drive unit, the clutch, the two plates that sticks together when the clutch is on. Mm-hmm. It's a magnetic one, and one had unscrewed a little bit, so it was tilting, so it wasn't perfect fit. Mm. So then it moved a little bit, but not as strong as it should be.
No.
The good thing is that we have two autopilots now, because I did the installation separately. I left all the old equipment, so now we have two working systems.
Yes.
Almost redundant.
Yeah, and yes, and now you know how everything works in an autopilot.
Yeah,
almost.
Exactly. Yeah, so if you need help with the autopilot, I'm the guy.
Yeah.
At least on the Najad 405. Yeah. So do you want to hear what we have done?
Yeah. They want to, they think, yes!
Yeah, finally. What have you been doing all these days?
Yeah.
We checked the rig. We, mm-hmm. we haven't done that since Lanzarote.
No, since Las Palmas.
Las Palmas.
Mm-hmm.
And so up in the mast and checking that, no problem
mm-hmm.
that I could see.
No.
And we also measured the height of the mast, because we weren't sure. We said it was like we can't go under 20 meters,
And now when we come to the United States, we really want to try the waterways, and then it's lots of bridges there, so we really want to have the exact...
And the standard height of the bridges on that in the waterways are 65 feet. Our mast is 64, including the antenna. Mm-hmm. And then the top antenna is quite flexible, so... Yeah, it's 19.4 meters above water.
Yeah.
So that's good. Yeah. And we've done the maintenance of the winches. Lockers and cupboards and the bilge.
Yeah.
The silicone, the rubber all around.
Yeah.
And we have gone through the fishing equipment. We did. You did a lot of polishing all the stainless steel and gel coat and we oiled all the hinges.
Yeah.
I sharpened all the kitchen knives.
Yeah.
And then we got a new dinghy, and it was, and also the we got a huge engine. It's super good, but it's heavy, so I had to improve the attachment on the push pit. We had some gel coat damages or dings, which we filled up just to make sure it doesn't come in water into the fiberglass, and we cleaned the hull. That's amazing.
That we do every week.
Yeah, I've done a lot of sewing. I improved the spray hood or just and the cover for the cockpit table.
Yeah, and the life. Yeah, rescue.
The life buoy.
Yeah.
And pockets for all the lines on the mast.
Mm-hmm.
And sun cover, the big sun cover, the boom sun cover, the boat hook and the winch handle that we want to have near the mast so it's always available. We did some special things to do fix that. We put some extra eyelets and attachment on the boat so it's more stable now. And we cleaned the diesel tank and we sealed the ventilation on the front starboard side.
Yeah.
Wow, that was a good list. So wish us luck on the crossing to we're heading for Charleston, and from USVI to Charleston it's approximately 1200 nautical miles.
Yeah.
And we we will be there in 10 days, maybe a little bit shorter, 10 days with the
When we leave from the USV, it's 10 days.
Yeah, and we have 330 up to
USV.
To USV from Martinique.
Yeah.
So that's 2.5 days. So we leave in the evening here.
Oh, yeah.
To be there in the morning.
Yeah. I'm excited. And you can follow us when we leave when we leave USV St. John. You can follow us on Predict Wind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we're going on a flottillia with approximately 60 other boats, not heading the same to the same port. Some go to Florida, some go to the middle of the US as we are,
yeah,
and some are heading north, even up to Canada straight away.
Yeah, it was one boat who was going the whole way to Halifax.
Yeah,
that's a long way.
But the plan is now to go there and sail up to Maine, around the Boston area, going to Nantucket and Newport.
That's on your own. It would be so fun to see the
Statue of Liberty.
Yes,
that's the only bucket list thing I have.
Yeah, from the sea, from the sailboat. That should be really nice.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And so the thing is, when we are up in there in August, the plan is to stay there during the hurricane season and then go back here in November via Bermuda and down to Bahamas. But if things aren't improving, so all the islands are closed and the restrictions are too hard, we have the option to go back to Europe again in August.
Yeah.
So let's see what's happened.
Yeah, and I don't know if we said it was called the Salty Dawg.
Yeah.
Yeah, the flottillia.
Salty Dawg.
Salty Dawg. And it's 69 boats leaving the 10th of May.
Yeah.
And it's mostly Americans, but it's also people from...
One Swede.
Yeah.
Swedish boat.
No, Norwegian.
No.
But it's from UK and from South Africa. Yeah. So it's from the whole world.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Good. And keep on following us. And don't forget to like and subscribe.
Yeah, that's very important. You can do it down in the center here now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. See you.